Doug Bataliones joins us again to tell us more about an NFL player who held a football camp here in the Philippines. Go ahead, Jack.
Yes, Denise, Filipino-American NFL player Cameron Bynum of the Minnesota Vikings has been in the Philippines since January, not only to trace back his Filipino roots, but to also help introduce the sport of American football to Filipinos. The 24-year-old safety from the Vikings came home for the first time in June last year to conduct relief operations in typhoon-struck Leyte. His wife, Lalaine Haddad, is from that province. They recently tied the knot in an intimate ceremony in Boracay. Bynum said doing outreach and community projects helped him go full circle. He discovered that his grandparents were from Baybay, Leyte. Yesterday, Bynum wrapped up his two-day football camp. He has become more involved in bringing American football to the country through flag football and even tackle football leagues. He hopes to bridge the gap between his professional life in the U.S. and his Filipino blood. Bynum has been busy introducing his sport to the children in the communities they visit. This kept him in shape and got a chance to meet other players from different clubs. Bynum believes the Filipinos have what it takes to make it to the NFL. And hopefully, with his camp, more Pinoys will take interest in the sport. He is scheduled to go to the U.S. this July in time for the NFL training camp. Denise?
Thanks, Jack. The Philippine Health Department assures Filipinos receiving antiretroviral drugs, there is no shortage of these medicines. This comes after a group of Filipinos living with HIV raised concerns over unstable supply. Jeffrey Hernandez has the details.
These are antiretroviral pills, or ARB, probably the most important medicine ever discovered for people living with human immunodeficiency virus, or HIV. The drug does not eliminate the virus, but stops it from multiplying, allowing those living with HIV to lead a normal life. But the PLHIV community in the Philippines is raising the alarm, saying the supply of the life-saving medicine is dwindling.
There was a time sometime in May na nagsimula nang magbigay ng 1 month na lang. So nakaka-trigger siya, no? Nag-aalala yung mga community, ang mga client mismo. Bakit 1 month na lang yung ibinibigay? Ang problema ay hindi malinaw yung sagot ng doktor o ng treatment hub. Whether meron bang stock out or meron bang shortage. Ang isang malinaw lang na sinabi ay padating pa lang kasi yung manggagaling sa DOH. So yun lang yung malinaw.
The Joint United Nations Program on HIV/AIDS, or UNAIDS, regular intake of ARVs is very important because it lowers and suppresses the viral load, making it undetectable in the body. Undetectable viral load means it can no longer be transmitted to their sexual partners or to an unborn child of a mother living with HIV.
If ever matigilan, even for a short amount of time, yung regular treatment of taking of the antiretroviral medication, there's a very real possibility na tataas immediately yung viral load. So what would that mean? If ever the person living with HIV does not use protection in engaging in sexual intercourse, there's a high possibility na makatransmit siya. Even if undetectable siya previously, pwede siya makatransmit ulit.
The shortage of ARVs may also lead to further increase in the number of new HIV cases. This April, the health department recorded 1,240 new cases of PLHIV, which translates to 50 new cases daily. This figure makes the Philippines the fastest growing HIV epidemic in Asia and the Pacific region.
It's beyond 200% already since 2010 yung pagdami ng cases natin. So any increase, no, as long as it still is going up, na continuous year on year, medyo alarming pa rin siya because it would point to a continuing transmission of infection, meaning ang pag-prevent natin ng pagdagdag ng new cases are not effective.
Under the HIV and AIDS Policy Act, it is the government's obligation to provide PLHIV's access to quality treatment. But the health department and the Philippine National AIDS Council assure the PLHIV community that there is no reason to worry. The health department says that the low stocks of ARVs could be attributed to unprecedented increase in the use of TLD.
Ang action ng DOH is madali nila itong solusyonan dahil nakakakuha sila ng mga stocks sa iba-ibang mga trading hubs, no? So ganoon ang ginagawa nila. Pero in terms of shortage dun sa mga regular ARVs natin, wala po tayong shortage.
Dapat ma-implement natin ng maayos yung batas. Kaya kailangan makita namin talaga ano yung priority ng gobyerno. Ang inaasahan natin ay ang hindi lamang yung quality of life, yung assurance na kami ay kikilalanin ng ating gobyerno, ng lipunan, na mga taong may dignidad din. At the end of the day, we can live beyond HIV.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. earlier instructed the new health secretary, Dr. Ted Herbosa, to prioritize programs that will help stop the increase in the number of new HIV cases in the country. Jeffrey Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.